倦怠な夢の後の何もない世の中じゃそうは愛しい思いも負けそうになるけど静止がしないメッチ。
Hello everyone and welcome to Digimon Manga Special 11 of Lost in Translationmon. I'm Mei and this time I'm joined by my wonderful guests.
Sab, hello.
I'm Sporky, hi.
So again, it is 7:30 and the sun is shining in Australia and it's still quite warm. I have my fan on me and it's, you know, I might go for a walk after this because it'll still be light when this finishes. And my my hosts are in less fantastic circumstances.
Wait, is it 7 p.m. where you are?
It's 7:30 p.m. yeah.
Oh, it is 8:30 a.m. where I am and it's -7 degrees and it is very snowy outside.
It is 2:30 in the morning and it is, what is that in Celsius? About -7.
Jeez. Oh. And we have the sleepy Sporky cast again.
Indeed.
But we're here to talk about Digimon Next Volume 2, and we're here and we're queer and we're homostasis.
We are homostasis.
As we established last time, yes. So we'll just jump into synopsis. So Chapter 7 starts off how the last volume ended, with them fighting Canon Beamon, and Galmon and Agumon have a plan. And I always do like when Digimon have plans. It's always quite good.
Yeah.
And Galmon keeps calling Agumon a lizard, which I really like.
Yeah, he does.
So Canon Beamon sends the Fan Beamon off to chase Agumon, and Galmon acknowledges that he might actually die because he's quite weak. And he can't just fight a perfect level because he's just a child level. And he says he can at least buy some time so the others can be safe. Which I think is just like, I feel like the manga addresses dying more than the anime ever did.
Way more. Also, it happens to Galmon twice in this volume. I think I'm going to start counting this.
Yeah, Galmon and almost died a bit in the first volume as well, so Galmon's not having such a good time.
No, he's not quite a Leomon.
Yeah, he's almost... Well, he hasn't died yet, but almost. Very, very close. He grabs Tankdramon's egg and says, "Look, I have your Conrad's egg, and I demand the humans are released." And Canon Beamon just attacks and doesn't care, and the egg is just destroyed. And so is Galmon's leg.
Yeah.
And Galmon... Yep.
I'm not sure whether Galmon does it on purpose or not, but he asks Canon Beamon why Barbamon is massacring Digimon. And this is where we learn a little bit about he wants to cleanse the world of old Digimon and then return everything to data once more and then like create a new digital world. So we learn that Barbamon's plan is to essentially recreate the digital world. We don't know why specifically yet, but this is like...
Yeah, we find out in the next chapter though.
Mm.
Does he want to kill all Digimon or just the artificial ones?
He wants to kill the illegals and reset all the other ones, I believe.
Okay.
I think he wants to if we go by what Canon Beamon says, it's return everything to data and then recreate a new digital world. Essentially, it's a reboot, where humans haven't, etc., etc., which we found out in the next...
But not one where time gets set back.
Yeah.
Mm.
So he's a bit like Yggdrasil in X Evolution, right? Like, wasn't the plot of X... Like, maybe I'm wrong, maybe because the plot of X Evolution sort of makes sense. Maybe. Possibly.
I mean, X-Evolution literally goes to another world, but it's pretty close.
Yeah. Weren't they going to kill all the non-X-antibody Digimon, think?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I don't know. It's very confusing. Something about an X-antibody is in there somewhere.
Either
they're going
to
kill the X-antibody Digimon, or they're not going to kill them, and then the ones who do have it evolve into X-Digimon? I don't know.
So what happened was that Yggdrasil picked 2% of Digimon, maybe at random, it's not clear, to go to the new world. The other 98% were killed with the X program, except for the ones who developed the antibody, and they got super strong.
Okay.
Yes.
I can still not explain the plot of X Evolution to you, even though you've just told me.
That's because it's not
X
good.
Is the best, though.
Yeah.
He's the cutest, I think. Goemon X.
Yeah.
Or Palmon X.
There's a Palmon X.
Pretty into the X version.
I think there's X everything, especially the original like Adventure Digimon. I'm pretty sure they'll have X versions. Maybe. I might be wrong, but I know Palmon has one. And Goemon's is the best. That's all I know.
I think Monochromon X is pretty good, though, because it's just sword. Just more sword.
Mm.
Alright. Everything needs more sword.
Even more sword. The only step is sword. Galmon says that he only has one wish, and it's to protect you. And then he yells out for Tsurugi and Agumon to protect you. Agumon destroys the Fan Beamon, and you then hugs Galmon's dying body. Agumon evolves, gets a new power, which I'm really loving this mechanic of, like, oh yeah, you get new attacks, like in Pokemon. You just unlock new attacks. You don't always have the same attacks. Like, it shows some form of progression and getting stronger besides evolution, because in the anime it's always just like, oh, you...
They have exactly one plan.
They,
Like, oh,
he uses Digisaw. He, like, presses the Digivice against his forearm, and then he installs a new attack on Greymon, which is very Digimon. Like, we don't really see this.
Mm.
The only time we've really seen something like this is with the Card Slash, where they give them a temporary attack. But this is more, he's literally installing something onto his Digimon, which is weird.
Cool. Yeah, and because it's Digisoul, it's like, it's something that's from within him.
Mm.
So it's not just like a card and a Card Slash. It's like, this is part of me. And that's what I like about the Digisoul.
Yeah.
Because it's like, it is part of you, and you're putting part of you in your partner Digimon. And it seems like more than just someone who's just standing on the sidelines.
Mm.
Definitely. And yeah, I'm really into the illegal Digimon in this. It's pretty neat.
Especially Marine Angemon.
Yeah.
Galmon gets bandaged up. May can't speak again. Galmon gets bandaged up, and then Barbamon is talking to the Commandramon about eliminating the illegal. And then in the next chapter, we find out that his motivation is that Digimon are living and should not be treated like pets. They're their own living entities. And Digimon should have the right to live on their own and do whatever they want instead of being controlled by humans.
This is where we learn about, they're called Arto-Digimon, which are...
Yeah.
Essentially, there are two types of Digimon. There's ones that are from the digital world, doing their own thing, living over there. And there are the ones which are raised in actual VPets. So they are they're like Digimon raised by humans. And I mentioned it earlier, but like, knowing this gave me a bit of a complex whenever I raised VPets.
Right?
Barbamon says that humans throw away Digimon if their evolutions fail or if they have wrong paths, etc. And they're treated really poorly. So... If I'm raising a Digimon and it evolves into something like I don't want it to, or the evolution fails, I even to this day cannot just reset, because I'm like, no, Barbamon will get mad at me.
Yeah, that's fair.
And I think a lot of people who...
Barbamon's got a point.
Yeah, like I'm pretty sure a lot of people who have risen VPets is like, oh, I didn't get the one I wanted, I got the poo one, I'm going to reset. And they don't think anything of it, but this is sort of an interesting dynamic of, what if the Digimon was sentient? They wouldn't want you to kill the Digimon just because it evolved differently, or, oh, I'm bored with it now, I was only using this for my own, like, desires and because I was having fun, but now since I'm bored with it, I'm just going to kill it. Or, you know, oh, it lost a fight, I'm going to reset it now.
Yeah.
And he's really upset about this, and that's why he wants to create a new world, because he wants to separate it from the human world, and the only way to separate the world is to create a new one. So, like, reading this, I was just like, oh, I actually, like, this sounds really reasonable. Like, yeah, sure, I can understand why you would want to separate the two worlds if Digimon were being killed.
I do get that. On the other hand, in order to keep Digimon from being killed, I'm going to kill all the Digimon.
It's not necessarily killing, though. It's just returning
them. It's resetting them.
Yeah, it's returning them to their eggs or just their data, and then restarting the world without that connection to humans, and then letting them live. And it's nice to have a villain who isn't evil for the sake of evil and wanting to rule the world. I know he does want to rule the digital world a little bit, but he wants to rule the world without humans being involved in it.
That's sort of true. Although I think he does kill a whole lot of them, because they've stopped turning back into eggs now.
That is a valid point.
Yeah, or maybe it just wasn't shown because it wasn't relevant.
No, the previous volume made a big deal out of how a lot of them don't turn back into eggs anymore, and it's a whole thing.
Oh.
So, yeah, no, he is sort of Hitler still.
Mm.
Yeah.
Whoops.
I think we've just established that Hitler did nothing wrong.
Whoa. Okay. Jeez. Okay. All right.
That's me joking.
Obviously.
So let's pop a little pin in that and come back to that later.
Yep. So, meanwhile, Ami is freaking out, and she thinks that you should go home. You doesn't want to go home, and he says, look, I was dying in the real world, and I needed a heart operation, and now I'm able to do things and go places. And he's having the time of his life.
Oh, yeah, I'd never go back.
Have we ever had this before? Yeah,
I would not go back. Even, like, you know,
this,
my life in the real world's okay, but, like, even though I had a split toe...
Hmm. Have we ever had this before in another season? The only one I can really think of is maybe Frontier, where there's some sort of handicap on a person that they don't have in the digital world.
V-Tamer.
Just V-Tamer. Her name Ray.
And she was a paraplegic in the real world. She could walk in the digital world, but she actually was fine with being disabled. Handicapped. It was her brother that didn't want that, and she was like, "Yeah, I'm fine to go back. I'm fine to for this." And you know, it's no one's fault. It just sort of happened. And her brother was just like, "Oh no, oh my sister's handicapped. I can't deal with this. It's all my fault." And she's just like, "Come on, dude. I don't really care. I'm not even that mad."
Yeah. I do like
how I sort of get where you're coming from.
Yeah. So we find out the Trailmon travels according to the will of the passengers, which I like. Like, this was never really explained in Frontier when we had the Trailmon. Like, I feel like the Trailmon
we're
so
kind of
far...
fixed a lot of the time in Frontier.
Oh, in Frontier, yeah. Especially in the English version.
Yeah. Oh man, the old one with the German accent.
Yeah. Yes, Fraulein. That was my awful German accent, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Ewan and Galmon get off during the night because he doesn't want Galmon to fight anymore. Then they're walking through a desert because it's Digimon, and they're dehydrated, but they get to a plot-convenient oasis. And there's lots of plant Digimon there, and there's a really, really, really tall Sunflowmon.
It is very tall.
Like, it is huge. Very large.
Like, I think, isn't the one from Savers maybe twice, almost three times the size of Yoshino?
Yeah, but she's not like a building like in this one.
Yeah, this is fully like four stories, five stories tall.
I really like the shot of her in the train later.
Oh, yeah. When she's all like curled up.
It's kind of cute because she's very large.
Indeed. I love it.
Then Sunflowmon says that she's the leader, and she says how the desert used to be Greenland, but Barbamon distorted the world, and they're traveling at the moment to the Atla Kabuterimon forest. Then some Merimon and Petite Merimon show up and burn down some Digimon, and Galmon says that Merimon isn't good or evil, but the Demon Lord messed him up. So this is like that situation that we had a lot of in Adventure, which is like, oh, but that's usually a good Digimon, except that he's saying, yeah, Merimon's not good, but he's also not bad. Like, he's just sort of a guy.
Mm-hmm. Kind of into that.
Yeah. Then in Chapter 9, we find out that Merimon is, of course, being manipulated by Barbamon, and basically sets Galmon on fire, and this is a pretty horrifying scene where he's just setting everyone on fire.
Hmm.
Yeah, definitely. We're really into the body horror type stuff in this.
I think this one of the worst is in a chapter or two. There's something really horrific. But yeah, there are some really horrifying images in this, especially like this series of books.
Yeah,
same in V-Tamer. There's a lot of gore, like a lot of Digimon just being cut in half. Like that was always just a bit. I mean, I'm not sensitive to it, but I'm just saying it's unusual to see in Digimon like that level of violence. It's always very cartoony violence. Mm. Like, oh no, you threw some leaves at me.
They get a few weirdly scuffs intense. And marks on them, but they're never like missing limbs, etc.
Yeah, like at one point in V-Tamer, Zero just gets like his wings impaled, and he looks very in pain by it, and needs to like it's not gone in the next scene. He has to go to hospital and get it recovered and repaired.
Mm-hmm. And Zero almost dies.
Multiple times.
Yeah, well, I was thinking of the evolution thing, that being an ancient Digimon or whatever was a bit thing.
Oh yeah, the overwrite.
That's it.
V-Tamer was good. I'm enjoying Nex so far though, which is good.
Yeah. I think it's turned into one of my favourite Digimon things.
That's good. Atmon's still my favourite.
Yeah, Atmon's still up there. Absolutely.
But Atmon doesn't have my new waifu, so.
Mm. Oh, Eri's pretty waifu.
That's true, she is.
I cried so much in all her episodes. If you haven't watched Atmon, everyone should just watch Atmon.
Atmon and then listen to our podcast. Highly recommended. Yeah, I was actually listening. I've been not great lately, and I've been listening to all of the Atmon episodes. I haven't watched them, but I've been listening to your discussions, and it's been really, really good. And I've got the last one to listen to later on, but Atmon's great.
I hope you enjoy.
It's really good.
It's so good.
It's just so good.
We decided that since I was going to hate O2 at least more than a little bit, we're also going to pair that with Atmon for next season.
That's good.
Yeah, should be fun.
So you should have waited until Frontier, because Frontier is worse than 02, in my opinion.
I think we're going to do that with Tamers and Frontier at the same time.
Okay, yeah, you counter a bad with a good.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, sure, Digimon can be bad, but it can also be pretty good.
Uh-huh.
Surugu, because I'm reading my typos, Tsurugi shows up and evolves Zogamon. The fire attacks makes Merimon stronger, and Galmon says he shouldn't measure a Digimon just by DP, but by compatibility, because of the fact he's a big thing of fire.
This is the same thing that happens in Savers, isn't it, with the Merimon?
I think it also happens in Adventure, so I think it happens whenever there's a fire... No, it's Agumon and Merimon. Agumon's just stupid with Merimon, because it always happens with an Agumon.
That's true. Although, in Adventure, It just totally works when Bergeron does it.
Yeah, because physics. I mean, it worked when Greymon did it in Savers, right? I don't know. Agumon can't attack Meromon, I think is the point.
Yeah, that's a bad idea.
Galmon sees a black orb, and everyone gets set on fire, and Yu activates his Digisoul, which causes Galmon to evolve to Galgamon, and we find out that he has the Beast Digimemory on his forehead. So we're just sort of getting a theme of like, oh yes, the main characters all have the Digimemories.
Yep.
Yu can't handle the Digisoul, and Galgamon's evolution is sort of incomplete, and I really like this. Like, it sort of, shows that, maybe Yu doesn't have the strength to actually evolve his Digimon, and he passes out midway through the Digisoul charge, and so of course Galgamon's evolution's incomplete, and that's just really interesting to me.
Mm-hmm.
Geo Greymon calls Galgamon Eyebrow Dog, which I'm a huge fan of, by the way.
I mean, if you look at Galgamon's design,
I like that they have nicknames.
Eyebrows. There are prominent eyebrows.
Oh yes.
He's got eyebrows for days.
Eyebrows for days. His eyebrow game is so strong. Galgamon is able to separate the flames so that Geo Greymon can grab the orb, and then a gun appears in his hand as he destroys the orb.
Yeah, he sort of,
which no one else sees.
Punches the orb, and then as the orb, like right before the orb explodes, there's like this barrel of a revolver appearing, and no one sees it.
Like, it's Rise Greymon, right?
Yeah.
I just like
how immediately after the orb explodes, Geo Greymon's like, "What happened? Did anyone else see that?" And everyone's just like, "Yay, we did it!" And Geo Greymon's just, "No, just me.
Then." Okay, guess that's fine. This is
a normal thing.
I love Geo Greymon's face when he sees the gun. He's just sort of like, what? And he has like, his eyes go wide, and he looks just like kind of cute, which is like almost chibi. Like, his expression is just sort of like, it's so anime, but he's a big scary dinosaur. I don't know.
I'm not sure what the proper expression is for. My arm just became a gun for like half a second.
Well, if you're a dinosaur, I think your reaction to your arm becoming a gun is the same as your reaction to everything, which is, roar, I'm a dinosaur.
That's fair.
Like, your expression doesn't change. It's like, I'm a dinosaur. I don't have facial emotions. I don't emote. Meromon says sorry, and he looks like a little boy who's been told off. He's just sort of filled up like, I'm sorry. Oh, shucks.
But everybody reassures him that it wasn't his fault, which is cute.
Yeah. Which, I mean, it kind of was. I guess it wasn't his fault explicitly, but it's... I don't know. It is interesting that we've shown Digimon who are in support of Barbamon, and then Digimon who are being forcibly forced to follow Barbamon.
Forcibly forced.
Forcibly forced, like with a black orb, which is black gear again,
I guess.
I
about to say, completely not a black gear.
Yeah. Like, we've never done this idea before, we promise. But at least it's different enough. It's not a gear, it's an orb. Yu says he doesn't want to be a coward or a weakling anymore. And then the forest Digimon are traveling, and then we find out that the forest they're already traveling to has been destroyed, and there's not much of it left.
There's just a crater in the middle of a forest. It's really unsettling.
Yeah.
And then in chapter 10, we see an injured Commandramon being basically straight up murdered. And then I had this thought of like, wait a minute, doesn't this make Barbamon's whole point kind of, I don't know, hypocritical, because he's destroying a Digimon for being weak or injured. And the Commandramon's like saying, no, I can still do it. I can still live. I can still fight. I'm fine. It is but a flesh wound. I'm fine. And he gets murdered.
Turns out he's still evil.
Yeah, it turns out
it could just not be Barbamon's will, because it's about the commandments, which are the people in charge. Maybe it's whoever's in charge of the Commandramon are saying, you've got to be strong, Commandramon, otherwise there's no point having you. So maybe it's not directly Barbamon's will.
Or Barbamon could just not actually think what he's telling everyone. He's just using that as sort of motivation to keep people on his side, because if he said, oh, I'm just creating my own world for my own, so I can have my own world because I want to, no one would follow him. But if he has like a reasonable like, oh yes, I'm creating my world so, you know, we can separate from the humans because they're killing Digimon unnecessarily, maybe he's just, that's a lie. Maybe he's lying. Maybe he's, because he is a bad guy after all.
Sorry, I was talking over there, you cut out. It could also be that he's just a hypocrite.
Yeah, that too. We see that there's a girl watching, which is Sporky's new favourite character.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, she's pretty waifu.
I don't know anything else about her, but it's a really good outfit.
Yeah. We find out that Knight has murdered Atla Kabuterimon and just drops his horn near the girl, which, now I've just said that, I realise that's a bit of weird phrasing that I've just said. Whoops. Tsurugi and Co. arrive at the forest, and there's a Co-Kabuterimon who is injured and says how Atla Kabuterimon was murdered. And it turns out that he was an illegal Digimon with a Digimemory, which is like, oh, rip, I guess.
Yeah.
We find out that Pekmon evolved to Yatagaramon, and then Ami knows about Night, and she hears about him. She's like, oh, how, we can ask him how we can get home. And everyone's just like, no, no, Ami. He's evil. And she's like, oh, it's okay. I have no moral compass. I'll flirt with him. It's fine. I'm like, okay, well, I guess she knows what she wants, and she wants to go home.
Yeah. Yeah, not into that.
Sho then gets a migraine from playing video games too long, because, like, as you do. Yeah, and he's able to go home. So that's an interesting thing that we find out, that he's not trapped. He can go home whenever he wants.
I'm assuming that the other kids can too, they just don't know it.
Maybe. They just have to take off a headset, but I think that he can't. Also, he's able to access the game from his own room and his own internet, so I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I get the feeling that he's physically in the digital world, and he uses his VPAT, his Digimon Mini, to jump through, like, to open the gate, like a D3.
That was my thinking, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So he's not his room, he's physically jumping into the digital world, and then jumping out. I mean,
Evil Kidder yells at his mom after he gets back from the digital world. We've never seen that before.
Yeah, because his mom's worried about it.
Shut up, mom, let me play my video games.
She's like, oh, you've been in your room a lot, and we find out that he's got, like, 10 locks attached to his door.
Right.
So you're probably right. He probably is transporting to the digital world, like, physically.
Yeah.
We find out that he has a photo of himself, Norun, Tsurugi, Ami, and you, which is very interesting, because I wasn't aware that we knew you beforehand, but I guess we do now.
We also found out he's a bird nerd.
Yes.
And it's weird, because none of the three of them seem to remember, especially Norin. Where they're like, somebody asked me, you know, what Digimon mean to me, but I don't remember who. Like, it was 3 years ago. It wasn't that...
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I guess if you're 11, like...
Yeah, okay.
Well, you would be like 4 or 5 or something. He's like, he gives me the impression of like the 8-year-old or 7-year-old character in Digimon, right? Wouldn't 3 years ago be like a lot of his time ago?
But the other kids don't really have that excuse. Yeah. I mean, okay, they were 8, but still.
Look, if I saw someone dressed like that, I'd remember. Friends.
Yeah, even right. If you look at them in their photo, everybody else looks pretty regular, and then no one is just wearing this extremely intricate dress.
Maybe she's like Kwaru in Angelica. Like days.
I could be. I want that dress. I really want that dress.
So we find out in chapter 11 that 3 years ago, Norun approached them and asked them what Digimon were to them. Then we see a Nanomon is telling Barbamon that Sho was speaking to Norun, and we find out that Nanomon is the strategist. Then in the next scene, Yu is talking to the train, and it's kind of cute, and he says he wants to be strong like Tsurugu Nichan. Gamon is jealous that Yu is talking to a train,
this
and
is
I
so
find
cute.
That was, found that really, it was so cute.
No, I'm like, not doing anything. I'm not watching or looking at anything. I'm not bothered or anything.
He's such a tsundere. He's a tsundere eyebrow dog.
He really is. It's so good.
I love him. Ami is looking for Pichimon, and we find out that he's with Agumon, and Ami punches Agumon.
Yeah, it looks like they're about to fight, and then Agumon's just like, oh no, we're just training because Pichimon's a fresh level, so it doesn't know any attacks, so we're just getting ready to fight. And Ami is, she says she doesn't want to hurt Digimon, but she fully punches Agumon.
Yeah, I guess it doesn't count if you're doing it, like, if you're a human doing it, right?
That's fair.
Like, also, Ami's fairly brave for punching an Agumon, right? Mm.
But then he poops on her face.
Yeah.
They could have done without that.
Then she strangles him.
Oh, yeah, like, he's got no pupils.
That's not
he's
an unreasonable up. Reaction to that.
Like, you know, the last person who punched an Agumon was Masaru.
That's true. So I think that makes her the Goggle Girl.
Yeah, basically. Ami is the new Goggle Girl, and I love her. It's fine. I like her fashion sense.
Yeah.
So basically the whole argument was that Ami says that Pichimon doesn't have to evolve because that's her thing. She likes raising Digimon because she likes raising Digimon, not so they can evolve or so they can fight. She just likes to look after things.
Mm-hmm.
Which isn't... I said this in the last episode, but it's quite an interesting dynamic of just like, oh no, Digimon aren't just for fighting, we can be friends with them and without fighting.
Yeah, into it.
Yeah, they arrive at a hot spring, and there's an Angewomon and many Tailmon, which I really like this because I know I speak about this in basically every podcast I'm ever on, but in Digimon World 2003 the Tailmon was running the inn, and it reminded me of that a lot. Everything reminds me of Digimon World 2003, and I can link it to basically anything that ever happens because it's the best game.
One of these days you're gonna have to actually finish it.
Yeah, but I for some reason my PS2 freezes whenever I do anything on Digimon World 2003. I'm not sure if that's because it's a PS2 playing Digimon World 2003 or if the disc is not good.
Probably the disc.
Yeah, but I'm like, I don't want to risk buying another disc because they're quite expensive.
I'll just take it into like a game shop and ask them to resurface it.
Oh yeah, I guess I could do that. I mean, I've still got the save file, so like it would work on everything, which is good because like nowadays it's just like, oh, it saves the cartridge. You ruin the cartridge, you no save file.
Yeah, or you move to a different DS.
Yeah. So Angelwoman is flirting with Tsurugi and Army gets mad. Then she goes into the onsen and Angelwoman asks if Army likes Tsurugi. And then we find out the onsen is really oil and everything is fake and a trap. Yeah, and then Angelwoman attacks Pichimon.
Is Angelwoman getting Tsurugi drunk? Because it sure looks like he's drinking sake there.
Yeah, and then, yeah, because Army says, oh, you shouldn't be drinking, that's irresponsible. And Tsurugi says, oh no, it's juice.
Also, in that shot, Tsurugi has got his head fully buried in Angelwoman's breasts.
Oh, yes.
He really does. Like, they make a point of saying he really likes girls with big breasts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The guy knows what he likes, eh?
I guess.
Hey, fellas?
Army feels personally attacked, and I understand.
And Army's just like, well, this is uncomfortable. I'm 11.
Yeah. So she leaves, which is an appropriate response.
Yeah. Like, and well, this is making me uncomfortable.
Oil, which is even
yeah,
more.
Which is really gross.
Yeah.
And all the foods, insects, yeah. And yeah.
Which Agumon doesn't care, which is I know it's not quite in this part, but I'll just say it now. But Agumon just like, hey, this is delicious. Can we get more of this? Because it's such an Agumon thing, right?
It definitely is. I like it.
So Pichimon is able to use Protect because it's an illegal, and it's that's the illegal ability that they have.
Hmm.
Angelwoman was really a Nanomon, and the Tailmon were actually Hagoromon.
This bit with Angelwoman exploding into a Nanomon in a robot suit is just horrifying.
Oh, it's body horror.
Yep. It's fully, skin peeling off, and there's oil and machinery and cage.
So into it.
Yeah, this is horrifying. But I like it, but, it's a bit scary.
Angel Woman's face, it's like she's laughing as she just explodes.
Yep.
Yeah, I feel like if I had, this in a dream, I'd wake up in a cold sweat.
It's not fun.
I could see that.
But no, it was a bit too spoopy at that point. Then Army remembers her mother dying and says that Pichimon is part of her family. Pichimon evolves to Marine Angelmon, and it's an ultimate and puts everyone to sleep. And Army remembers somebody asking what Digimon are to her, and then Agumon's eating the trap food because he's Agumon,
yeah.
And I love him.
I'm pretty sure we've got the record, the highest possible record for warp evolving from baby one all the way to ultimate.
Yeah, it's a pretty big step, and I'm glad that Army's Digimon did that. I think that's pretty cool. I always wanted to see Marine Angelmon do more stuff, because I always do like Marine Angelmon, and it was in Tamers for a bit, but I think we're shown that Marine Angelmon doesn't have any, maybe offensive abilities, and all the abilities are, really, really strong passive attacks.
I was about
right?
to say, you can also sort of see how this Marine Angelmon really works well with Army, how it's not aggressive,
it's a good
attack, it just... It heals, it helps, it protects. It's not an aggressive Digimon, which I really like for someone whose whole mantra is, I don't raise Digimon to fight, I raise them to just be nice and I help them.
Yeah.
And I think that would have been an interesting evolution for Joe's Gomamon to have in Adventure, because Joe was all about the healing and not necessarily about the fighting. And I remember when I first knew of the evolutions when I was a kid, the evolution wasn't Vikemon and it wasn't Plesiomon, it was Marine Angelmon.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's
still
pretty cool.
It's a bit of a jump from, Ikakumon, Zudomon, Marine Angelmon, but it's a fine jump between Gomamon, because it looks kind of like Gomamon.
Hmm.
I'd be pretty into that, though,
Because it fits Joe. Joe
it
is
really
a doctor.
Yeah.
And I'm fine with him having two evolutions. Everyone can have two evolutions if they want. I'm all for, is it Belial Lilymon or something? That's not Belial, it's,
Bancho Lilymon?
Bancho Lilymon, yeah, it's like a, yeah, don't know where I got Belial from, I guess Vamdemon. Lilymon's Vamdemon now, guys, by the way.
That's fine, that's
check
good.
Yeah, I'm a pretty big fan of Marine Angelmon. Pretty cute, very strong, but not aggressively strong, which is good. They don't have to always be aggressively strong.
Yeah, it's neat having a support healer character.
Yeah, because Digimon's always been about who can launch the bigger fire attack, and with Marine Angelmon, it's more just healing and protecting, and because that's what Army would do. Army wants to protect everyone. She wants to protect her Digimon and raise her Digimon. Doesn't want to fight them or kill him. I like it.
Mm-hmm.
So then in chapter 12, there's some kids that are playing Digimon, and some guy resets his Digimon for being weak, and Tsurugi's friend yells at him, and I kind of like that.
Mm.
We find out a lot of Digimon live at Light City, and importantly, and this is really important, and I want everyone to know this, there's a Nanemon in the crowd.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Next to a Teriamon.
Yeah, which is like, you know, the best character in
Wait,
Frontier.
Wait, did you say Nenemon or Neymon? I'm sure you just said Nenemon.
I said Nenemon, didn't I? Yep. Yes, I've been thinking about Cross Wars. Nenemon.
Nene has the weirdest hair.
Yeah, see she me does. Flip. I kind of love her.
See me Nenemon?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. They're going to see Pichimon and... Why can't I type? They're going to see Piximon and Army brushes Tsurugi's hair because she wants him to look nice. Because she just wants... Like, her goal is she wants to go home and Piximon might know how to get home. So she's very, like, we see that she's driven to get home, and that's completely reasonable. Like, she doesn't want to be in this world. She doesn't necessarily care if it gets destroyed, which is kind of weird because she likes Digimon, and we know this at this point.
Kind of against her character. Although, I feel like she's just memeing at the moment, which is just, I'm panicking, I just want to go and do the thing, I don't care about anything else right now. My prime directive is just to go home, that's all I want to do. Then we can deal with everything else.
Yeah, but, I mean, she did just say that Pichimon is her family, though. Mm. And it does sort of contradict, like, oh, I don't care if Pichimon dies, which is what Barbamon's goals are, I just want to get home.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah, she's probably just freaking out. So then there's a battle Trailmon, which is just basically Trailmon with more guns. And it's led by a very scary Mummymon, who is a lot scarier than in 02, I feel.
Mm. Yeah.
Agumon evolves and attacks the attack train. And then we see that the city's getting airbombed. No one wants the attack to stop. And then there's a Zanzibarmon who is there and he's ordering them to get the 3 Digimemories from the kids and he's going to go do that. And then the kids' Trailmon evolves to battle form because his goal is for all the passengers to arrive safely.
Yep.
And I dig that. And I believe that's it for this volume.
I thought there was a little more where he does the fight for a bit.
Oh yeah, he does do a fight.
Because Geogreymon gets just wrecked.
Oh yes, because Mummymon's strong. It does sort of have that feeling where I'm just like, man, I just want to read more. Like, this is actually quite good. Mm. What were your thoughts?
Pretty into this. This... Oh, go ahead.
I like... You can go ahead if you want.
Okay. Yeah, no, I'm enjoying the story. It's a little more mature than I typically expect from Digimon, which is neat. There's some real, you know, neat nuance to it. Trailmon. It's pretty cool, the whole thing where he just does whatever the passengers want. Oh, we kind of skipped over... you getting off to go hang out in the desert for a bit. But, yeah.
Yeah, I'm digging the Trailmon in this as well. Like, they seem a lot more, like, developed than the ones in Frontier. I feel like they're more like characters, and the fact that they just travel by whatever the person inside them wants, I feel like that's a pretty almost well-developed thought. It's interesting.
Yeah, well, and they can just make train track and tunnel to wherever they want to go.
Also they evolve.
I like how it's set up for the next episode, well, the next chapter, sorry, which is going to be some epic train versus train style fight, which sounds really interesting.
Yeah.
I think pacing-wise, if there's 4 volumes in next.
Yeah.
And if you look at volume 1, which was basically set up, volume 2, it's now we've been told what the big bad's plot is, which is, you know, to reset the digital world without humans. And we've seen the briefest glimpse of Neo, which is that weird tadpole-looking thing in the jar. We see that for, like, one frame. And then we see we've met loads of the illegal-type Digimon. We've learned slightly more things about the main character's partner Digimon. And I think pacing-wise, it's going in a nice direction.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate that, you know, the bad guys have clear, specific goals, and so far they're just winning.
I think because... V-Tamer was how many volumes? 12?
9, I think. I might be wrong, but I think it's 9.
So we're looking at about half the length for next, for the entire story. So I think nothing feels too condensed at the moment, but then I don't think there's anything that we've had so far that's dragged on for too long. It all seems like each plot point is given enough time, and then they move on to the next thing, which I really appreciate.
Yeah, and there's no, like, quote-unquote filler bits, because even in V-Tamer, like, every so often we'd get, you know, we'd get an Omake, or we would just get a chapter where you can sort of take it out. It's good, but you can sort of take it out, like, it's not relevant to the whole storyline, but V-Tame is definitely, like, the longest. I'm pretty sure, like, all the other mangas for Digimon after this are all, like, 4 volumes or 2 volumes.
Yeah.
So they're very much shorter in comparison. V-Tame was quite long.
And sometimes Daisuke shows up in the middle of a tense situation and we're just gonna pretend that's not the case.
Yeah, why not? Also, it was good when Daisuke showed up, like, in the
Just they were in the middle of a story and then they ignored that for a little while.
Yeah, it was just sort of like a potentially not canon Omake, but it was fine.
Yeah.
But yeah, next seems to be like one plot point to the next, and it's, you know, it's following things, and they go places, but nothing is, like, they're not going to places that just to have a filler episode, like in Frontier, like, oh, let's just go on this train and get off at the filler graveyard of trains.
Mm. Yeah.
Shrug. What were your favorites, like, characters and stuff?
Well, no one has best design.
I love Marine Angelmon so much. I would die for this mon.
Yeah.
It's really hard to pick, actually, out of characters. They've all got their own special things going on and their own, what's the word? I can't words. I like all the characters for their own reasons. There's no one mm-hmm. I particularly don't like, but I like them all for their own specific things.
Mm.
I'm not super into Knight, because he's just the generic emo character.
Yeah, he's a bit like Ken, kind of. He's a bit like also the bad guy in V-Tamer, Neo.
Yes.
I appreciate that he, unlike Ken, at least so far, doesn't seem to have been brainwashed. He's just a dick.
Yeah, and he doesn't have any reasonable reasons for doing that. Like, Neo, you could almost see, like, oh, okay, he blames himself for his sister's disability and wants to make it right by creating a world where she can walk, and she can walk in the digital world. And that's his motivation. And that's sort of, like, almost reasonable. And he was, like, you know, driven to madness by his own grief. And that's fine. Like, you're allowed to be driven to madness by grief. That's fine. Sho just seems to not be a nice person.
Mm. Yeah.
Do we know Do we know his motive yet? Can't remember if
no.
told
not yet.
Not. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think we know anything besides, like, he's maybe friends with the main character, sort of. That's all we know, but he's been like it doesn't look like he's emotionally compromised Neo, almost called him Knight, and or like being brainwashed like Ken.
I do like the hints we've been given in this volume. We've been given that brief flash of this version of Neo, which is the tiny tadpole thing in the jar. We've been given that shot of the gun arm that GeoGreymon gets, which we find out about, etc. We get shown the photo of them all together. So we get these, even the tiny bit with Norun, like, we don't really know what her deal is. Being given all these new little clues as to what's happening or what's going on, it's nice to have these new things to question whilst we wait to read the next volume and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed it. I think I'm enjoying it more than volume one so far. Like, volume two, I mean.
I would agree with that.
It seems better, and I'm enjoying it more and more.
I think it's because you haven't got a setup. A lot of times you have to deal with, like, but the setup of something isn't as great, because you've got to learn about the characters. They have to be told a few things, get some exposition out the way. But I agree. I think that I've enjoyed volume two more than volume one.
Any more thoughts from either of you?
I don't know if I needed another Meramon with a black ear.
Yeah.
I almost thought of it like as sort of like a reference in a way.
Yeah. I just don't think it was particularly strong or
I do think the bit where Yu goes to the desert is the weakest part of this volume.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it's filler, but of the parts where you could probably cut out, I do feel like you could have probably not had that bit.
Yeah, yeah. You could also say that, okay, he doesn't want Galmon to get hurt, so he's going to wander through the desert and possibly be attacked because he knows that there are Digimon who want to kill him. I just feel like that wasn't very thought out by you, but you can just say that, oh, it's because he's young and he didn't know any better and he didn't actually think through his actions.
Mm. Yeah, yeah. But yeah, they even get warned, hey, going out into a desert's a bad idea. And he's like, no, it's fine. Galgamon will protect me. But
I don't want Galmon to fight, but I also want him to protect me. Well, like, sorry, child, doesn't work out
okay.
that way.
He will protect me from heatstroke.
Yes. But besides that, it seems to be fine. Like, yeah. I'm glad, because after Volume 1, it was just sort of like, oh, are they just doing the V-Tamer storyline again with the creation of a Digimon? And then this one seems more unique. Like, okay, let's separate the world from humans because humans are awful. Like, that is a pretty strong reason for destroying the world and resetting it.
Mm. Yeah, and you know, humans are pretty awful. That's just sort of true.
Mm. And as I said before, like, after the first time I read this, learning that as part of this the lore of this universe is humans have Digimon in their V-Pets and you raise them and they are this separate kind of Digimon and they are so mistreated because they are raised by humans and humans don't treat them properly, and that's always stayed with me after reading it, and I think that's great.
Yeah.
It's weird that the message is kids, don't play with our toys.
Maybe. Or it's if you do raise them, don't get rid of them just for not being strong enough or for not evolving the That's way you fair. Want it to appreciate them for who you are, for who they are, sorry.
But yeah, I don't have any extra thoughts. I just want to make a quick apology because at some point my Google Home started playing music, and it's because it picked up me saying, "And that's my baby," and then it played a song. So I'm going to listen to the recording about what I actually said. But apparently I told my mom, not because we have two Google Home, not the Google Home behind me, but the Google Home that's in my room, which is further away. So I'm not sure why one Google Home picked it up and the other one didn't. That's the problem with dealing with a smart house. So if you hear some background music, I'm really sorry.
I'd also like to apologize because you could probably hear I've got two cats who are in this very cold house with me at the moment. And I live on a road where about every half an hour you'll hear a fire truck or an ambulance or a police car. Guaranteed, every time I sit to record on a computer, one will go past. And there was one earlier, and then my cat's been particularly loud because she wants something. I don't know what it is yet.
Aw, she wants pets.
She's not very well. She has hyperthyroidism and she now has to have pills.
Oh, poor thing.
And it's fine. She has it in cheese. She's not complaining. But
Cheese is good.
Anytime she wants anything, she now comes up to me and starts meowing directly into the microphone.
Oh no.
It's effective.
But I didn't hear too much cat noise.
Good.
But I also live on a very, very busy road, so the door to the balcony is open, and it's a miracle upon miracles that no emergency vehicles went past during that time, because they always go past very loudly. It's a very busy road. But yeah, I think I'm done expressing my thoughts. I liked this. I like next. I'm enjoying it.
Mm.
I'm looking forward to reading what's next. Ha 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 ha.
I like it. I like where it's going. I like the ideas that they've come up with and the plot that they've got and the moral and the lessons they want to teach you, which is don't disrespect things just because you think they're not good enough.
Yeah.
It's nice.
And yeah. I feel like all of the Digimon manga is pretty good. What that I've read and what I've heard, all the Digimon manga seem to all be better than the seasons, which is interesting, really.
I do think the level of the quality, especially in Vitamer and Next, it's up there. It's up there compared to most seasons.
People love the Cross Wars manga, and even people who didn't like Cross Wars love the Cross Wars manga, and I'm really excited to read it. I flipped to the last couple of pages just because I was flipping through it because I just wanted to look at some things, and my god, the ending, it has Butterfly.
Oh. Huh.
It's obviously, not the sound, it's just the lyrics, but they're all Shatmon singing Butterfly on his microphone, and that's not really a spoiler because it's not
that's plot just very relevant. Cute. That's
but cool. it's Butterfly. It's the whole lyrics to Butterfly and all these scenes of this epilogue, and it's just okay. All right. I didn't expect to have these emotions, but I'm having these emotions.
I wouldn't mind giving it a read. I've not read it. I've recently rewatched Cross Wars, and it holds up fairly well. A lot of people don't like it, but I still think it's worth a shot. Especially,
I like Cross Wars
Part 2 and 3. I love Young Hunter so much.
It's a lot like Atmon, though. I'm watching, I'm just like, okay, this is a lot. I still think Atmon's better, but it seems like a very sort of ideas for
proto-Atmon. I'm pretty tepid on part 3, but the first two were really good.
I like Sparrowmon.
Yeah. It surprises me as I'm going through this.
Yeah, it has pew-pew guns, and it's a bird, and it's a sparrow, and it's a plane.
It's pretty great. It surprises me they haven't adapted Next or V-Tamer into an anime, because they would both be really good.
Even if it's just as a movie.
I think V-Tamer would definitely benefit the most, because a lot of Next is in other things. There's a lot of things from Savers, which is in here. I think to a certain extent there's a few things which you could see in some of the games as well, which are also in Next. But I think V-Tamer itself absolutely would benefit from whether it's a special try or if it's an actual series, it deserves some love because it's really good.
And also Taichi's precious and I love him.
Yeah.
He's my precious son.
I think I like that Taichi better.
Yeah, I think I do too. Also, his goggles have reason.
Uh-huh. That's a big part of it. They actually gave
reasons, and okay, I guess that's great. Also, Zero is the best.
Mm.
Yeah.
But I'm done with my thoughts. I'm looking forward to the next volume, and hopefully you guys will still be okay to record at 10. Maybe, like, we'll organize it so it's maybe on, like, a weekend, so it's during the day for me and
a
not
weekend
dumb o'clock
would be
for you
easier
guys.
For me, yeah.
Yeah, because I feel, like, I do feel bad that it's, like, 3:20 in the morning for you.
Yeah, that's
okay. I'm absolutely fine doing... in fact, for me, like, I'm normally awake till 6 in the morning anyway because of the way my work works. So if I need to be awake at, you know, 3 in the morning to record, I am absolutely fine doing that. I will not be sleepy. So.
Okay. But we'll talk about this, obviously, offline, and we'll work out a better time for next month because, like, I know I feel cool
video.
Doing this.
I do think, Sporky, you deserve to have some awake time, like being awake and not tired, because you've definitely... done the most to help out, like, being awake.
Oh, no, it's no big deal.
Weird hours.
Like, try to talk to me at 3 a.m. I'm not there. Like, I mean, like, I also sleep during the day because I'm possibly narcoleptic, which I'm getting checked out on Sunday, by the way. I'm going to a hospital and paying $500 to take a nap.
Jeez.
That sounds about right.
I hope I actually have something wrong with me, because otherwise I'm going to be really annoyed. Just because, like, that's still money. Like, using that private health insurance for the next 3 months before I turn 25.
Yeah.
But so May's going to be in hospital, so that's going to be fun.
It's fun. Hospitals are fun. I need to go. I keep going for the past couple of days. Well, the past, 2 weeks on and off?
Yikes.
It's fun. My kidneys
are
working.
I'm
going to
have a great time. Oh, no.
They're not sure why they're doing it. It's just, I'm on pills at the moment to make them do their job, but they don't know, and they don't understand why I need to take the pills. So.
Yikes. I hope that works out.
I'm glad that there were pills available, though.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, it's all right.
But thank you for both coming on, both of you guys. I love you both so much, and I hope that it was good to listen to, and yeah.
Yeah, I hope people enjoy this. I will not hear this, because I can hear myself talking, and I do not like that.
Yeah, I also don't like hearing myself talk, but I have to, because I edit.
I'm vain, so I listen to all of it.
Yay.
Good.
Well, hopefully hopefully there's no talking over each other like there was in the last one.
I feel like it was
hopefully
less.
You can hear me as well. I was recording clearly from the bottom of a well last time.
But thank you for listening, and thank you for coming along. I will record a quick outro after my wonderful guests leave, because I want Sporky to go to bed. I think I also want to spend some time with my flatmate, because he's gone skating without me, and I also want to go skating, but not without me, with me.
Skating sounds fun.
Yeah, we go skate parks now, which is fun. I decided not to wear knee pads, which is not smart, and I fell on my knees a couple of times, and my knees are hurting. But then it's okay, because when I got home, I immediately split my toe on a door.
Breaking yourself apart piece by piece, slowly but surely.
Yeah, and I've got my first speed skating lesson on Sunday too. So I hope my foot cooperates, because I'm quite good at speed skating and I want to do well at my first lessons. And I guess I won't be skating to my top ability if I have no toe.
Do you use skates or blades?
I have 3 pairs of rollerblades. I've got speed skates, which are inlines, and aggressive skates, which are inlines, and just a regular pair of skates.
I can't use regular ones. They are, no, I can't balance.
I've got to try quads. Like, I like skating everything. Like, skating's fun. I like speed skating the best, because speed skates are so fun and so.
I don't get how you're
so
supposed
huge.
To stop by just putting your foot forward.
That's fair.
I put my foot behind my other foot.
I don't understand how it works. It's scary.
I go skating about every 5 years, so, you know.
I can ice skate.
I don't remember how skate.
Helps.
I need to ice skate. Like, it's something I really want to do, but I haven't done
it. Ice skating's
really
fun.
Maybe one day.
Best bit of ice skating was once Yuri on Ice came out, and if you go ice skating, like, every half an hour they'd play History Maker. It was great.
I need to watch that.
It's really good. It's such a good anime. I highly recommend it.
See, I just make jokes about, you've heard of on Yuri on Ice, now prepare yourself for Yaoi on Blades.
I'd watch that.
It's like, no, or Yaoi on Solid Ground, and it's about some maybe roller derby girls who are in love with each other. I don't know.
I'd watch that.
I'd totally watch that. I love roller derby girls. I really want to try roller derby. Like, it's very violent, but, like,
don't you have
fun.
To have some sort of name as well? Like, roller derby names are quite cool.
Yeah, I would have Laura Mipsum.
Alright, I like it.
Like, Laura Ipsum. Laura Mipsum.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Placeholder.
No, I like
every
that
attack
a lot.
Is called
it's
the
very
placeholder.
Cute.
But thank you for coming on, and I will do a quick outro. But first I will say goodbye to Sam and Sporky, and thank you for coming on, both of you. You guys are great. And I'm waving for some reason. Why am I waving? I don't know, I'm just waving.
I'm gonna wave too.
Okay, both of you wave. Quickly.
I did.
I'm doing it. Okay. You might be able to hear the wind whooshing.
Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good morning.
And sleep well, Sporky. And good morning, Sam. Have good day-night times. So next time, we'll be reading Volume 3 of Digimon Next. The link dump's linked in the description. You can contact us and stay updated. You can email us at lostintranslationmon@gmail.com, or you can comment on this episode or message us on SoundCloud. You can follow us on @Translationmon on Twitter, and you can find us on Lost in Translationmon on Tumblr, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. We have a discussion thread on With the Will and a red thread in the Digimon subreddit, and we would appreciate if you would review us on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, and any other podcast listening app that you use, because ratings help people find about the podcast. We now have a website. You can vote in polls, check out our release schedule, and our blog posts. You can donate to our Patreon with linked description from as little as $1 a month, and that gets you access to a Melissa Slack chat group, but there are higher levels and more rewards, such as notes, early episodes, and more. And thank you to our existing Patreon supporters, Sam Krieger, who hosts a podcast called The Moncast, and was also on this episode, Wu Qinglong, who is on twitch.tv/WuQinglong, Metal Marmimon, Joe, Anime Guy, who is Anime Guy Kurosaki, then the number one on YouTube, Chuck Mon, Hirolato, who is @Hirolato on Twitter, Jason Morosky, Ryuchi, who is Frost Miragic on Archive of Our Own, Stephen Reeves, who is @WildWing64 on Twitter, Kaidawashi, Mac, Noam, Riku, Shisai, who you can follow @Shisai236 on Tumblr, Kyle, Delady Bugman, who you can read their anime blog on bugubaraga.wordpress.com, Tom, Glitchgoat, Azra McCool, Gene Hackmon, who hosts New World Sonata, a sci-fi fantasy audio drama podcast, Matthew, Anthony, who is @AntoClassic on Twitter, Lizmet, who is Alekmon on Tumblr, Sithobi, Ellie Vorg, who is Ellie Vorg on Tumblr, Sporky McForkinspoon, who was also on this episode, and also hosts a Digimon podcast called Going Digital, Megan, Kaliak, Neobu, The Time Optimist, Silverhead Freak 25, who is SHF25, tweets on Twitter, Harvey, Nicholas, and Anthony. And you can make a one-off donation on our PayPal, which you can find in the description. It's paypal.me/airdemon. Make sure to let us know for the podcast. We'll see you guys next time. Bye!